Hello everyone, I am Meghana P.S., Assistant Professor in Commerce, Government First Rate College, Paramsagra. In this session, I am discussing miscellaneous functions of commercial banks. In today's session, I am discussing one of the categories in functions of commercial banks, that is miscellaneous functions. Let's take a quick recap of previous session. The functions of commercial banks are categorized as primary function, subsidiary function, and miscellaneous function. In the last three previous sessions, we discussed about the primary function, that is accepting deposit and granting loans and advances. In subsidiary function, we have agency functions where bank acts as an agent, and we have utility function where the services are provided to customers as well as general public. Some of the utility functions which we discussed in the previous sessions are safe, deposit holds in banks and ATM facility, debit card, credit card facility, point of sale services, machines, mobile banking, online banking, foreign trade services, foreign exchange services, and publishing statistical data. These are some of the utility functions which we discussed in the previous session. Objective of this session is to understand the miscellaneous functions of commercial banks. By the end of this session, you are able to identify the miscellaneous functions of commercial banks. As we discussed in the previous session, the functions of commercial banks are divided into three types: primary functions, secondary functions or subsidiary functions, and third one is miscellaneous functions. Miscellaneous functions refers to the functions which are non-banking in nature, means other than the primary and subsidiary functions, the commercial banks performs various non-banking activities. Those activities are called as a miscellaneous function. These miscellaneous functions are as follows. The first one is social welfare programs, and the second one is entrepreneurship development programs, and third one is nodal agency for government schemes. Miscellaneous functions andre primary mattu secondary functions na bittu non banking activities enella banks commercial banks madutte avella activities miscellaneous functions alli barutte adralli modalnedu social welfare programs erandedu entrepreneurship development programs moornedu nodal agency for government schemes. The first miscellaneous function is social welfare program. As a part of corporate social responsibility, all commercial banks will engage in social welfare programs. First, we should know what is corporate social responsibility. It is also called as CSR. The corporate social responsibility describes the efforts of companies or it may be a banks towards the improvement of the society. As banks or companies are the part and parcel of the society, they have some responsibility towards the society to improve its life. So bank is not exemption in this case. So banks has to divert some of their funds towards this activities, which also improves the customer base of the banks. When it compares to public sector banks and private sector banks, the contribution of public sector banks is highest in CSR as compared to private sector banks. Let's see some of the social welfare activities are taken by the commercial banks and what are all the areas of social welfare programs of the banks. They are adoption of schools, livelihood programs, women empowerment, rural development, health and sanitization, environment protection and sustainability, etc. For example, the public sector bank, Canara Bank, it has two foundations. One is Canara Golden Jubilee Education Fund and another one is Canara Relief and Welfare Society, which works for livelihood and education, health and environment protection. And we have one more public sector bank, Union Bank of India, where it has Union Bank Social Foundation as its CSR practice. But through its foundation, it helps for community welfare, rural development, education, and healthcare. And also we have another public sector bank, SBI, where SBI has an SBI Foundation for its CSR activities. Its focus area includes healthcare, education, livelihood, skill development, environment protection, empowerment of women, youth and senior citizens. Like this, every public sector as well as private sector banks have their own foundations or CSR activities to improve the society. Social welfare programs and CSR adiyalli ella banks agirbodu, companies agirbodu, society na ondu samajada uddharakkagi maduvantaha ella chatuvatikegalu CSR alli barutte. ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಅದರದೇ ಆದಂತಹ ಫಂಡ್ ನ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆ ಫಂಡ್ ಇಂದ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಗಳನ್ನ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಅವರು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಯಾವ್ಯಾವ್ದಕ್ಕೆಲ್ಲ ಅವರು ಫಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಒಂದು ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಷನ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಲೈವ್ಲಿಹುಡ್ ಜೀವನ ಉಪಾಯಕ್ಕಾಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ವುಮೆನ್ ಎಂಪವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮಹಿಳಾ ಸಬಲೀಕರಣ, ರೂರಲ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಯಾನಿಟೈಸೇಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಷನ್, ಈ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಕಾರ್ಯಗಳಿಗೆ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಗಳು ಹಣವನ್ನ ಒದಗಿಸಿಕೊಡುತ್ತೆ. ಅದು ನಾನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ, ಅದು ಬ್ಯಾಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆಗಿರಲ್ಲ, ನಾನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಆದ್ರಿಂದ ಇವೆಲ್ಲವೂ ಮಿಸಲೇನಿಯಸ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಮಿಸಲೇನಿಯಸ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರಿನರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್. ಅದರ್ ದನ್ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡಿಂಗ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಏಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ CSR ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್, ದ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರಿನರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರಿನರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ means enhancing the skills and knowledge of an entrepreneur. This entrepreneurship development can be done through classroom sessions or training programs. Various banks are involved in entrepreneurship development programs. Some examples of such projects are RCETI, sponsored by SBI and Canara Bank, which means through Ministry of Rural Development, it is compulsory that in every district there should be one RCETI, Rural Self-Employment Training Institution should be there, which has to be sponsored by lead bank in the districts which carry out the entrepreneurship development program. And by S Bank, there is a one training institute, that is Skills Training and Enhancement for Development of Youth, STEADY, which is sponsored by Yes Bank. And we have ICICI Academy for Skills. This is also sponsored by ICICI Bank. The next miscellaneous function is Nodal Agency for Government Schemes. First, we should know the meaning of Nodal Agency. Nodal Agency means it is a direct concern of office which is deputed either for consultation or for implementation or supervision or combined of all these three activities for a particular scheme or a project initiated by the government. Bank will act as a nodal agency for various government schemes and their successful implementation in India. For example, Aadhaar enrollment. Here the banks are going to enroll for the Aadhaar as well as they are going to update for the Aadhaar. Here banks are advised to provide this facility in one out of 5 to 6 nearby branches. Next one is financial inclusion programs. What is financial inclusion means? The financial inclusion refers to providing financial services to the vulnerable sections of the society at a lower cost and in transparent manner. For this purpose, the government initiated PMJDY schemes, that is Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana, FLCC Financial Literacy Centers, Direct Benefit Transfers. So all these things are initiated by the government, which is implemented through banks itself. Next one is Direct Benefit Transfer Scheme. Here it means the subsidies of the government schemes are directly paid to the people through their accounts. Means here it reduces the corruption. For example, Ujjwal scheme, where the gas subsidies are directly transferred to the beneficiary account. And Vayu Vandan scheme, it is one of the offered by the LIC through which is initiated by government only, where it provides guaranteed pension. That pension amount is directly transferred to the beneficiary. Next one is Sukanya Samruddhi Yojana, which is a government scheme which helps foreign girl child. Okay, here it is a saving account by the parents of the girl child. It is also initiated and it is implemented by the banks itself. And we have PMEGP, that is Pradhan Mantri Employment Generation Program. In this program, the subsidies or the amount which is necessary for self-employment is issued by the government through bank itself. And PMJDY is one of the National Vision for Financial Inclusion Scheme, where it aims for a basic saving account for all the population of the country. Next one is Prime Minister Awas Yojana. It is also implemented through banks itself. Here, the subsidies are given for construction of home. So, these are some of the government schemes which are implemented and supervised through banks. So, bank acts as a nodal agency for all these schemes. Nodal agency for government schemes antandre, government schemes ina implement madodu, adanna melvicharane maduvantaha kelsavanna bank madutte. Aadhar enrollment irbodu andre aadhar card na ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಡೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಅದನ್ನ ಅಪ್ಡೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಡೋದು ಬ್ಯಾಂಕಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ವಹಿಸಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಷನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸಸ್ ಸಿಗ್ಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಮಾಡುವಂತಹ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಥ್ರೂನೇ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಮೊದಲೆಲ್ಲ ಈಗ ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ಪೆನ್ಷನ್ ವಿಡೋ ಪೆನ್ಷನ್ ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಕೈಯಲ್ಲಿ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು. ಈಗೆಲ್ಲ ಹಾಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಅಕೌಂಟಿಗೆ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ರೆಮಿಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಉಜ್ವಲ್ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸಬ್ಸಿಡಿ, ಅದು ವಾಯು ವಂದನ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪೆನ್ಷನ್ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ಇಂದದು. ಸುಕನ್ಯಾ ಸಮೃದ್ಧಿ ಯೋಜನಾ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಹೆಣ್ಣು ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಒಂದು ಉದ್ಧಾರಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತ ಒಂದು ಯೋಜನೆ. ಇದು ಕೂಡ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಖಾತೆನ ಮಾಡಿಸ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಷ್ಟು ಅಂತ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ನ ಗರ್ಲ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ನ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಕಟ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ. PMEGP ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಪ್ರೈಮ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಜನರೇಷನ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಗೋಸ್ಕರ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ನ ಗ್ರಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ನ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಕೊಡುತ್ತೆ. PMJDY ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಪ್ರಧಾನ ಮಂತ್ರಿ ಜನಧನ್ ಯೋಜನಾ. ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಒಂದು ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಖಾತೆ ಇರಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದೇ ಈ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ಇಂದು. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಓವರ್ ಡ್ರಾಫ್ಟ್ ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟಿ, ಪೆನ್ಷನ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್ ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟಿ ಕೂಡ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಂದ. ಇದು ಕೂಡ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಥ್ರೂನೇ ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಗೋದು. ಅಂಡ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಪ್ರೈಮ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆವಾಸ್ ಯೋಜನಾ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಒಂದು ಅಫೋರ್ಡಬಲ್ ಹೌಸಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಕೈಗೆಟುವಂತಹ ಬೆಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಮನೆ ಸಿಗ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ. ಇದಕ್ಕೂ ಕೂಡ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಲಿಂಕ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ನ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ಇಂದ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದು ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಇಂದನೇ ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಗೋದು. ಸೊ ಹೀಗೆ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ಸ್ ಗೆ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಒಂದು ನೋಡಲ್ ಏಜೆನ್ಸಿ ಆಗಿ, ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟೇಶನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತ ಒಂದು ಏಜೆನ್ಸಿ ಆಗಿ ವರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. Let's conclude this session. We discussed the functions of commercial banks, which is categorized as primary, subsidiary, and miscellaneous function. Apart from primary and secondary functions, the commercial banks are also performs non-banking activities. Those activities are called as a miscellaneous function. Some of the miscellaneous functions are social welfare programs, entrepreneurship development, and act as a nodal agency for government schemes. These are the four references for your additional reading. I hope you understood the concept of miscellaneous functions. Thank you for watching.